Hello Prepsters, welcome to the new video. So we have been getting a lot of requests from a lot of students to upload a video on the Infosys logical reasoning, right? So yes, as per the request, we have done it for you guys. Talking about Infosys logical reasoning, so guys, the questions are actually a little bit difficult from the rest of the logical reasoning questions that you see. A little bit difficult, I would not say very much difficult. Talking about the syllabus, so we have uploaded a video on the Infosys syllabus already, so I don't think it's a good idea to discuss everything over here again and waste time. So the link to the syllabus and any other relevant videos for Infosys can be found in the description of the video. We have also uploaded a video on Infosys aptitude questions as well, so you can find the link to that as well in the description, right? And yes. So guys, let us not waste a lot of time over here. Let us start with the questions and then we'll have a lot of discussions in between the video, right? Okay, so first question on your screen, it says, what day was it on 26th of Jan 1950? So let me give you some fair time over here, a time of 1 minute. Those who don't want the timer, they can skip the video, or those who want more time, they can pause the video. But I just want you guys to at least try the question before I explain it to you, because that will give you more confidence, right? So your timer for 1 minute starts now. Alright guys, so how do normally people solve such questions? You will calculate that there were zero leap years till 1600, and then you will calculate for 300 years, and then we'll calculate for 49 years, and then you will calculate for the 26 days of January, and then you will find the number of odd days and you will find the day which was there, right? But I would say there is a very important and interesting trick. If you can just remember one 12-digit number and one small formula, you can find it in 10 seconds, hardly. If you're interested, we can do that. So the thing that you have to actually remember is, so January, February, March, April, May, June, July, August, September, October, November, December. Cause see, calendars and clocks is one of the most favorite topics for Infosys, and they'll definitely ask you a question from you. So the code is 03 61 462 5035. That's the code, right? Now the formula is date plus month plus year plus leap year. If you can remember this, so this is a 12-digit number, right? People easily remember phone numbers of 10 digits. So this is a 12-digit number. You can easily do that. And then this formula, date plus month plus year plus leap year. So you have to find which day was it on 26th of January 1950, right? So what is the date? 26. Which month is it? January. So you will not write 1. January means what? 0. Which year is it? 1950. So we don't call it 50, we call it 50. So that is one catch in this formula. This trick and this formula is only applicable from years 1900 and beyond, not before that, right? So that actually means if you are talking about some year, let's say 2010, so you will subtract 1900 from it, and that would be the year. Month you already got, month you should write from the table. So what would be the year? 110. Year it was 1950, so write 1950, subtract 1900 from it, and 50 would be your year. What is leap year? So 50, right? Divide 50 by 4. So 4 ones are 4, 10, so 2. So leap year would be 12. Whatever year you get divided by 4 and whatever quotient you get, that would be your answer. So this particular amount divided by 7, and see now how many odd days do you get. So what is the total here? 20, 30, 38. So 88. Right? What is 88 by 7, guys? What is the remainder when you divide 88 by 7? The remainder is 4. 7, 1, 7, 18, 7, 2s are 14. So 4 is the remainder. So when remainder is 4, which day is it, guys? 4 is the remainder means there are 4 odd days till 26th of January 1950. 0 is Sunday. 1 is Monday. 2 is Tuesday. 3 is Wednesday. So 4 is Thursday. So which day? Thursday. So I hope you like this trick, guys, because this is very interesting, a very small trick. Hardly will take 10-15 seconds if you remember this and this. That's it. You do not have to do lengthy calculations in the exam. Moving on to the next question. So guys, yes, one important announcement is if you have any doubt onto any particular question in this video, you can definitely ask us out in the comment section of the video. And apart from that, the best 3 comments on this video will get the Infosys Prime video course for free. So what is Infosys Prime video course? We actually cover all the topics from theory to question solving videos. We also give you a lot of mock tests for practice. We also help you out in your resume building and interview preparation as well, right? So the link to purchase the Infosys Prime video course is available in the description of the video. For our YouTube viewers, we are also giving a discount coupon, so you can find the discount code in the description as well. So here's another question. I'm again giving you 30 seconds and your timer starts now. Alright, so guys, the question says, in a clock, the long hand is of 8 cm and the short hand is of 7 cm. So which is the long hand in a clock, guys? The minute's hand, right? So the minute's hand is 8 cm long and the hour hand is 7 cm long. If the clock runs for 4 days, find out the total distance covered by both the hands. We have to find the total distance. Most of the question, you have to find the total angle covered, right? Here you have to find the total distance covered. So let us say this is a clock. This is the hour hand, let us say, and this is the minute hand. So how much would be the distance covered by the hour hand, guys? That would be the circumference of this circle. For minute hand, this would be the distance covered, the circumference of this circle. So that is basically in one complete rotation, right? Okay. So what is the circumference? So let us first calculate it for the hour hand. Yes? Okay. So in one complete rotation, how much distance will it cover? 2 pi r, that is 2 pi into 7, that is 14 pi in one rotation. We have to calculate for 4 days. So guys, tell me, the hour hand completes one rotation in how many hours? In 12 hours, right? In 12 hours, it completes one rotation. So in 24 hours, how many rotations, guys? 2 rotation. So 24 hours is 1 day. You have to calculate it for 4 days. So 4 days, how many rotations, guys? 2 into 4, that is 8 rotations. So in 8 rotations, how many distance will it cover? If in one rotation it covers 14 pi, so in 8 it will cover 14 pi into 8, that is 112 pi. This would be the distance covered by the hour hand. Similarly, so now you guys can pause the video, you can find it out for the minute hand as well. So for minute hand, in one rotation it will cover 2 pi into 8, that is 16 pi, that is one rotation.
So the mini time completes one rotation in how many time, guys? How much time? In 1 hour, one rotation. So in 1 day, how many times will it complete the entire rotation? So it will complete total 24 rotations in one complete day. So in 4 days, it will complete into four. So it is 15365. So total distance covered by both the hands is 15365 plus 112. How much is that? 16485 is your answer. I hope you guys got it, right? Okay. What would be the answer for this one, guys? Find the next term in the series 11, 18, 29, 42, 59. So what would be the next term? I'm giving you 30 seconds. Okay, guys, so what is this series? So this is one of the most unique series. So 11. So what is 11 plus 7, guys? 18. 18 plus 11 is 29. Then 29 plus 13 is 42. And then 42 plus 17 would be 59. So they are adding 7, 11, 13, 17 and so on to the series. So what is this? So guys, this is actually the prime number series. I know a lot of you would have got no clue about solving this. So this is a prime number series. So what they are doing is they are adding the, consecutive prime number to each of the consecutive number. First they added 7, so the next prime number is 11. Next to that is 13, next to that is 17. So what would be the next prime number? After 17, it's 19. So what is 59 plus 19? 78 is your answer. Got it? Okay. So looking a question from coding deductive logic. Okay. So I'm giving you again 30 seconds and your timer starts now.
Alright guys, so let us see how we solve this particular question. So this is a question from again coding deductive logic, right, as I've already said. So rows is coded as 682 and let us first write it. Chair is coded as 73456 and preach is coded as 961473, right? So what normally happens in coding deductive logic question is for A they write 1, right? And then some calculations are done over this, maybe they square it, subtract it and a lot of things. But here when I saw it was pretty straightforward. How? For R 6 6 6. Let us check for some other word. Let us take A. For A it is 4, for A it is 4, for E it is 1, for E it is 1. So we got to know that for each particular letter there is one standard numerical value assigned to it. Yes. So now we have to code for search. For S 2, for E it is 1, for A it is 4, for R 6, for C 7, for H. So the code is basically 214673 is your answer. Cool. See, the logical questions will definitely seem easy when I'll solve it for them, but it actually counts whether you were able to solve it or not, right? Okay, a question from blood relations. Blood relation is one of the most favorite topics for Infosys again. So you can expect at least 1 to 2 questions being asked from blood relations in the Infosys logical section. So here's the question. I'm giving you 30 seconds and your timer starts now. Alright, so the question says A is B's wife, right? So let us plot A and B. A is B's wife, so I'll write minus for A, plus for B. They are a couple, so I'll put them in a circle. So this is the family tree that we actually follow in our Prime Video courses and all, right? Those who might have watched one video or two from blood relation from our courses, he would be able to more relate it, but still I'll try to give you an idea. So what we do is for female, we write a minus sign, for male we write a plus sign. If they are a couple, we put them inside a circle. And yes, in a family tree on the same level, so brother, sister, cousin, wife, husband, so they are all of the same generation, right? So same generation comes on the same level. A is B's wife and C is A's sister. So where will C come? Same level. C is A's sister, so minus sign for this. D is the father of C, right? D is the father of C. So that means D is also father of A, because C is sister to A. If D is father of C, so D is father of A as well. While E is D's son, E is the son of D. What is the relation between E and B? Who's B to E? B is the husband of E's sister. Yes, because E is the son of D. A is the daughter of D, so they are brother and sister. B is the husband of your... So what do you call the husband of your sister? Brother-in-law. So this became very easy when you use the family tree, right? Randomly solving this, a lot of confusion comes in when you apply it on your family. I don't know whether this question was possible or not, but in normal cases, you somehow or the other get stuck when the questions are actually tough, right? So we'll see such questions as well in this video, so you'll get to understand. Okay, another question on your screen. I'm again giving you 30 seconds. A question again from Coding Deductive Logic. Alright, in a certain code language, PIDDANA means you are good, DATOCPA means good and bad, TIMNATOC means they are bad. So you have to find what word stands for they. So a lot of people, what they do is they, right? First word of the state sentence, first word of the statement, so they answer it as TIM. That is wrong. I'll tell you how we find out the answer. So in this case, you have to compare. So there are three statements, right? Take one pair and compare them. Let us compare A and B. So what is common between A and B, guys? Dar is common. And which word is common? Good is common. So that means dar means good. Let us compare B and C. What is common? Talk. And here what is common? Bad. Now let us compare A, B done, B, C done, so A and C. When I'll compare A and C, what is common, guys? Na is common. And what else is common? R is common, right? The word R is common. So that means na means are, talk means bad, door means good. So now in this particular area, you know the meaning of na and talk, right? Na means are, talk means bad. So that means Tim means they. Got it? But yes, be very sure that Pit does not mean you. So technically if that way, Dar should have mean R, right? But Dar means good actually. So you never know. So you should never be like, yes, first word would be the first word here. No, that is not the case. Okay. A question from statements and conclusions. So I'm giving you again 30 seconds to think about it and I'll definitely help you out with the answer. And guys, if you have any doubts till here in any particular question, you can definitely reach out to us in the comment section, cause me or my team will definitely help you out with the solution. And yes, the top three comments in this video will also get the online, the Prime Video course for Infosys for free. So make sure you comment and get your answer solved as well as win the free online classes for Infosys. Alright, so in statement and conclusion, so what we have to actually find here is what is the speed of the train, and you are given two statements. And we have to see whether both the statements are needed or only one statement is needed, or even if both the statements are not sufficient for us to answer this question, right? So we have to find the speed of the train, right? The first statement that is given to us is train A crosses a platform of length 120 meter in 20 seconds. So guys, what is the time taken by a train to cross a platform? Time taken by a train to cross a platform is basically length of the train plus length of the platform upon speed of the train. Yes, those who have doubt onto this, go and check out on our speed, time and distance videos if available on YouTube, or else try to find out free videos of PrepInsta related to speed, time and distance. I would have explained it there, right? Okay. So basically what is speed? Speed of the train is length of the train plus length of the platform upon the time taken to cross the platform. Okay. So in the first, it is what is given to us. Train A crosses a platform of length 120. So the platform length is given to us. The time it takes to cross the platform is also given to us. So, but using only statement number one, we were not able to answer it because we also needed this length of the train. Let us see statement number two. Oh wow. So we wanted the length of the train, and what is given in the second statement? Length of the train itself. So this is given. So now what would be your answer? So actually we need both the statements to find the speed of the train. Both the statements are sufficient to answer it, right? So what would be your answer? Both statement A and B are needed to find this out. Let us say This was not length of the train and this was something else given to you. In that case, what would have been your answer? Both of them are not sufficient. Right? Alright. Another easy question from Coding Deductive Logic. Again, I'm giving you 30 seconds and your time starts now. Alright guys, so this is very simple. I mean, you can confuse it using I don't know what logics you use. It is very, very simple. Which of the following is used for washing clothes? So if orange is called butter, butter is called soap, soap is called ink, ink is called honey, and honey is called orange, which of the following is used for washing clothes? So what do you actually need to wash clothes? You need soap. Simple. And what is soap called? Soap is called ink. So what do you actually need for washing clothes now? You need ink to wash clothes. Simple as that. Just find out what you actually need and see what that is called in that particular language. That is the answer. A lot of people confuse it. They start drawing charts and a lot of things. I don't know how, but this is the best way or the simplest way to solve such questions. Okay, so a different question from blood relations. I'm giving you a minute's time here because it is a little tricky question. Let us see how many of you are able to find the correct answer for this. So your timer for a minute starts now. Alright guys, so the question is a little tricky as well, but not that tough. A, B, C, D, E, F, G are family members and there are two married couples in two generations of people living in the same house. So there are 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 people who are family members and there are only two married couples and in two generations of family living in the same house. So there are only two generations, right? A is the father of the spouse of C. A is the father of the spouse of C. Right? F is the maternal uncle of G who is not a male. So F is the maternal uncle of G. So of course there are only two generations. If one is maternal uncle and one is obviously the other part, so definitely they will come onto this particular generation line as well because there are only two generations. F is the maternal uncle, so I'll write a plus sign over here. And G, who's not a male, so G is a female. A is the brother-in-law of F, obviously. Yes, this is justified now. They are on the same level. D and G are sisters to each other. So let me write D over here. D and G are sisters to each other. E is the son of B. E is the son of B. C is the feminine gender. C is feminine. So this would be, let us say, anyone who is, but he is of the, he's male. Okay. So now, guys, we were told there are two married couples. So one we have identified here. So A, B, C, D, E, F, G. A, B, C, D, E, F, G. All seven are plotted. There were two married couples. So the only married couple possible, these are all brothers and sisters. He is the brother-in-law of this guy. So only this is a possible pair. We have to create that because it said there are two married couples. Again, so till here it is done. Now it says, so R. R was not included in this family, right? Some external element. If R is the husband of G, R is the husband of G. So R is an outsider. He may not be living in the same family, right? If R is the husband of G, how is R related to E? Who's R to E? R is the husband of sister of E. So brother-in-law. Cool. But your family, applying things on your family, that would have failed you here, right? Alright, a question from syllogisms. I'm giving you guys 30 seconds. Your timer starts now. All right, guys, so syllogism, right? So first of all, guys, let me tell you, the correct answer here is only one. Option number one, only one form. So guys, the problem here is, there are multiple ways of solving syllogism problems, right? There is Venn diagram. There is tick, cross, and some miscellaneous ways. Venn diagram is a wrong way to teach. Even I used to teach it last year, but now cause everyone has changed to tick and cross method and all the questions are formed according to the tick and cross method and the answers are also expected using the tick and cross method only. And if you use the tick and cross method, you will find your answer as option number one, that is only one follows. See guys, I know 90% of you would not know the tick and cross method, so there is no point of me explaining it here cause there is a little bit of theory included with it, and if you do not know that, it is a total waste of time if I explain it. What you guys can do is go check out our special video uploaded on the syllogism, because yes, this is one topic that I'm very sure that is available in the Prime Video courses. If not, you guys can either check your luck using the Venn diagram if you get the same answer, but 90% time it will be wrong. And yes, so tick and cross method, right? So guys, maybe depending on the comments that I get in the comment section, maybe we'll upload the theory or the syllogism video for tick and cross on our YouTube channel. If not, you guys just go and check it out, try to understand it and then try to solve it. But yes, it is very, very important that you know the tick and cross method, right? All right, guys, so that's all we have from the Infosys logical reasoning questions and answers. We'll definitely be coming up with a lot of videos in the future. So guys, keep commenting, and if I get a lot of comments, as I said, you will be getting the online classes for Infosys for free. That is the first thing. Second thing is, yes, if you want the syllogism video to be uploaded, make sure you comment so that we plan on to uploading the syllogism video on our YouTube channel. Apart from that, guys, the Infosys Prime Video course, right? So the description and the coupon code is available in the description of the video. The point here is, yes, we cover everything in our Infosys online classes, be it logical, be it aptitude. So there is also one special topic that is called the crypt arithmetic that is included in the logical part, but that is one total different topic, and we'll definitely be uploading videos onto that on our YouTube channel. But yes, that is also something that we take care of very carefully in our online classes. So make sure that, you know, you have gone through that properly, check that out once. And yes, cause around 85% of the people who purchased our Infosys online video course, you know, cleared the first round of Infosys, right? And then interview and resume preparation will also help you out with that. So make sure you go and check out the link available in the description. Apart from that, guys, those who want notifications about placements, any other news related to placements, make sure that you are a part of our social media handles, that is WhatsApp, Instagram, Telegram. So the link to join all of them is given in the description of the video. So make sure you go and join them so that you never miss out on to any important opportunity related to placements. Apart from that, guys, yes, last but not the least, make sure that you have subscribed to our YouTube channel and also clicked onto the bell icon so that you never miss out on any important video that we make live. So I think that was my time, guys, and thank you so much. I'll be reaching out you out in the next video. Thank you.